This is the VOA Special English Agriculture Report. Less than a third of people in developing countries own or have any official right to the land they live on. Development experts say gaining land rights is important for reducing poverty and increasing economic growth and food production. Poor people can then use the land as security to get bank loans. Land records can also show foreign investors that the land and the rights of those on it are legally secure. Foreign demand has increased in recent years for agricultural land in Africa, Asia, and South America. UN Habitat official Clarissa Augustinus in Nairobi, Kenya, says, when an investor goes to the government and says, I want a piece of land, the government looks on their maps, which show that that particular piece of land is empty, and they give it to an investor. But when the investor goes there and looks at the land, he sees that it is fully occupied by a tribe or a family or whatever. Forcing the people off the land can harm the investor's image. Ms. Augustinus says ownership documents like deeds and titles are rare because establishing property lines and recording land is expensive. UN Habitat says the answer for some countries is to create a series of steps in gaining land rights, a so-called property ladder. First, people could receive a simple document or starter title to the land they are on. They would be safe from the threat of being forced off the land by the state or wealthy buyers. Higher steps would provide greater rights. Finally, a majority of a community could decide to allow individual ownership of the land. Namibia, Uganda, Tanzania, and Zambia are among the countries adopting property ladders. Ms. Augustinus says Ethiopia has already provided 20 million land certificates on the lower end of the property ladder for about $1 each. In Southeast Asia, the United States Agency for International Development is working on a project to help Timor Leste develop property rights. The first step is an official certificate recognizing a landholder's unopposed claim. East Timor separated from Indonesia in 1999. The Indonesian army had destroyed land records and forced communities from their land to break up resistance. For VOA Special English, I'm Alex Villarreal. You find live English lessons Monday through Friday at the VOA Learning English page on Facebook. You can also read, listen, and learn with MP3s and texts of stories at voaspecialenglish.com.